हेलो फ्रेंड्स, ई डॉट अकेडमी इज गोइंग टू स्टार्ट कंप्लीट कोर्स सीरीज। सो इन दिस कोर्स सीरीज वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कंप्लीट थियोरेटिकल पार्ट, ऑल न्यूमेरिकल्स एंड मैक्सिमम केस स्टडीज, सो दैट यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू मिस एनीथिंग एंड यू गेट थ्रू इन द एग्जामिनेशन वेरी वेल। ओके, सो हियर इज द फर्स्ट चैप्टर starting with the unit 1, that is called exchange rate and forex business, and this is the part 1 of the chapter 1. So we are going to start exchange rate and forex business. So first of all, we have to understand what is forex. So in the world trade, in the export import of commodities, cross border movement of manpower and capital travel, tourism and export of services all necessitate the need for exchange of currencies of one country to another. For example, let us suppose that you are visiting USA in a holiday trip. So when you reach USA, the Indian currency will not work there. So for that purpose, you have to exchange Indian rupee in USD, or you can say US dollar. Or we can take one more example. Let us suppose that one US tourist is coming to India, then US dollar will not work out here. So he has to exchange that US dollar to Indian currency. So this necessitates the exchange of currency of one country to another country. Now we are going to see some of the terms here, like export. So export, like good manufactured in India and sent to USA, will be paid in US dollar. And then what will happen? Then Indian exporter will need to visit bank and get converted that US dollar into Indian rupee. And same scenario will happen with the import. Let us suppose that import of a capital good from Germany to India will be billed in euro. Then what will be requirement? That importer need to visit the bank to convert that rupees into euro, because he has to pay that company which is located in Germany. Like Indian importer or exporter, the US dollar or euro is the foreign exchange. Understood? Means Indian importer and exporter will have to convert that Indian rupee in US dollar or euro. That US dollar and euro will be called as a foreign exchange for that Indian importer and exporter. And similarly, American or German importer exporter, the Indian rupee will be the foreign exchange for them. That means for we Indian, the euro and dollar be the foreign exchange, and importer or exporter of other country, the Indian rupee will be the foreign exchange. Okay. Now, as per the FEMA, that means Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999, how this foreign exchange is defined? So all deposits, credits, balance payable in foreign currency, or any draft, traveler check, letter of credit and bills of exchange expressed or drawn in Indian currency and payable in any foreign currency are called foreign exchange. Means all deposits, credits, means when you are doing any business, whatever is payable in foreign currency, that is called foreign exchange. Similarly, any instrument payable at the option of DRAI or holder or any third party, if they are wishing, okay, I want to convert that instrument in the foreign currency, then also this foreign exchange will be applicable. Okay, so now for that purpose, because exchange is not so easy, like if you want to convert $1 in Indian rupee, approximately nowadays you have been 76 rupees. That means $1 equal to 76 rupees. Similarly, euro dollar, maybe I'm just taking hypothetical example, 86 rupees. So all foreign currencies, they are having their exchange rate, and this is called agreed rate. So on this basis, this agreed rate, the foreign exchange takes place. Okay, moving ahead. Now, what is this foreign exchange market? Because when the exchange is taking place, there is need for the foreign exchange market also. So foreign exchange market comprise a large spectrum of market, in which the participants include individual, business entities, commercial bank, investment bank, central bank, cross-border investors, and speculators across the globe who buy and sell currencies for their needs. Okay, so in foreign currency, what happened? It is only the communication system-based market where there is no boundaries. I mean, there's no physical boundaries. And this foreign market means foreign exchange market operate round the clock. There's no boundary, there's no brisk wall, there's no market, only telephonically, okay, only communication-based market. Okay, like nowadays, because communication system has increased, so this market is taking place round the clock and there's no boundaries at all. That means you might have seen the vegetable shop where the people are keeping their shop there, they are selling in the physical market. So foreign exchange is not having such type of physical market because it is very vast area. It's covering global markets. It's also called global market. It's covering entire world like this. And now we'll see who are actually the participants of this foreign exchange. So I'll just see once again here. Central bank is here. Commercial bank is here. Investment fund managers are here. Forex brokers are here. Corporations are here. And any individual can also participate in this foreign market, foreign exchange market. So we'll see one by one, like central bank. What is the role of central bank? In India, central bank is called RBI. So Reserve Bank of India, what is the role of Reserve Bank of India? So it manages the forex market and using currency market strive to reduce the volatility and smoothen out the value of their home currency. So that means they control the whole of the forex market so that Indian rupee is not become so volatile. That means it remain stable. Okay. And all commercial bank means you might have seen that you can see S Bank, City Bank, ICICI Bank, Access Bank, Canara Bank, Indian Bank, all Bandhan Bank, including private public sector banks. They also offer exchange of currencies to their big and retail clients. And hedging and investing their own assets and liabilities so as on behalf of their client and also speculate on exchange rate movement in the market. That means they also go for the investment. They want to earn profit and they want to hedge. Hedge means to reduce risk. Means if in some currency the loss is going out, so they will purchase some other currency, the profit is there. Or if they think, okay, the rate of this currency will go down, so they will immediately sell out that. So this is called hedging. And speculate means they immediately make profit. Like they will think, okay, the rate of the future US dollar will go. So they immediately purchase the US dollar so that they can make the profit. And within 1 or 2 days, they will sell out to make the profit. So that means this is called hedging and speculate. And moving ahead. Investment and fund banks, like what investment fund and bank fund managers, they do, they're moving fund from one country to another using exchange market as a vehicle for investment, as also hedging. Some of the investment fund managers, they also go for the making profit from one country to another country. And corporations, so you might have seen the website, picture of five here. Google is there, Amazon is there, Apple is there, Microsoft is there, General Motors is also coming, the corporation. So they also invest in foreign currency to make profit and for the trade purpose. And even for the speculation purpose also, they invest in foreign currencies. Okay. And forex brokers. So you might have seen nowadays, many forex brokers are there who act as a middleman between the participants, many participants. Okay. Like in India and US, Euro, so many nowadays forex brokers also, they also participate in the foreign market. And not only the one individual, also ordinary or high net worth, they can also invest in foreign market. They go for the trade, they go for the personal need also. I just took example, like we are going to USA, then you have to purchase the US dollar, and after returning back you can to sell US dollar. So that means individual also, based on their need, they also participate in this forex market. So this was the first class. So we'll continue our next class. In this class, we have studied what is the Forex. Just I have given the introduction. Please stay tuned with my next class. We'll continue. Thank you very much. Bye.